Hello everyone. Today we are going to discuss how to represent the real numbers on the number line. So as you can see here, I have written down a question which states that represent 2.665 on the number line. Now we have discussed in our earlier class about the decimal expansion of real numbers. Now this decimal expansion will help us to represent those numbers on the number line. Now let us see how to do that. Say for example, here I have taken a question that represent 2.665 on the number line. Now how to do that? So let us begin. First of all, as you can see here, this is the number line. On the number line we have 0, the positive numbers, as well as the negative numbers. But our main focus will be 2.665. Now this number 2.665, what do you think? It lies between which two numbers? Yes, of course, it lies between 2 and 3. As you can see, 2.6. So this 2.6 will lie between 2 and 3. Now, what we need to do is that we have to magnify this portion between 2 and 3. We know that between 2 and 3 there are other numbers as well. Say for example 2.1, 2.2, 2.3, 2.4. So that thing only we have magnified here in the next number line. So we have magnified the region between 2 and 3. So we will write the numbers, or the decimal numbers you can say, in between 2 and 3. So here it is 2.1, 2.2, 2.3, 2.4, 2.5, 2.6, 2.7, 2.8, 2.9. Now we have to see the next decimal place, that is 2.6. Then after that 6 again, and then 5. So definitely this decimal number 2.665 will now lie between the next two numbers, that is 2.6 and 2.7. So we have to find the numbers in between 2.6 and 2.7. So we will magnify this portion again between 2.6 and 2.7. We will get other numbers that lies between 2.6 and 2.7. So those numbers are 2.61, 2.62, 2.63, 2.64, 2.65, and so on. Now still we will not stop, because we haven't reached our number yet, that is 2.665. Till now we have reached till 2.66. So this 2.665 will lie between 2.66 and 2.67. So we'll magnify this region again, and then we'll write here 2.66, and on the other end 2.67. Now let us write the numbers in between 2.66 and 2.67. So those numbers are what? 2.661, 2.662, 2.663, 2.664, 2.665, 2.666. So wait, we got our number 2.665. So here it is. So I have marked it with a circle. So as soon as we get our number, this magnification process stops. So I hope you all have understood how to get the numbers that lie in between the other numbers. So this process of magnification, or you can say this process of visualizing the representation of numbers on the number line through magnification process, is called the process of successive magnification. Why successive? Because we have magnified successively the numbers that lie in between the numbers. First we have magnified the numbers that lie between 2 and 3. Then we have magnified the numbers that lie between 2.6 and 2.7. Then we have magnified the numbers that lie between 2.66 and 2.67. And thereafter we have got our number which we need to represent on the number line. So I hope you all have understood it. You can try out other examples that are given in your book by the same method, by the same process. Sometimes it might also be written as 2.6 bar. Suppose some questions are also given in that way. So nothing to do. And we know that 2.6 bar, if it is given, then it will be 2.6666. Then in that case, what to do? Then in that case, in the question, it will be given to you that find it out till 4 decimal place or 5 decimal place. So till then, till that decimal place, you have to represent it on the number line through this process of successive magnification. So that's it then for today. Thank you and have a nice day.